How's it going, guys? Today we'll talk about the glitch effect. It's very popular in the media today, and it's a part of the recent VSDC update. Let's go ahead and have a good look at it. Create a new project and import a video file to VSDC. If you want to apply the effect to a part of the video, cut it out. Alternatively, just select the entire video layer. Now go to the Video Effects menu, scroll down to Special Effects and select Glitch. Good job, you've applied the effect. For your convenience, there are 8 presets for the glitch effect in VSDC. You can either use one of them or create your own. Let's see what we have here. In the right-hand side menu, there are 7 parameters. Preset. These are pre-designed effect variations, and you can save your own by clicking the plus button. Glitch transfer power. This is the main value, defining the movement of the blocks an image breaks into. Glitch effect power. This is the value defining the effect inside the blocks. Finally, glitch intensity. This is the value of glitch intensiveness. Fields number 5, 6, and 7, with the names Use Stage 1 to 3, are responsible for the effect fine-tuning. You can display up to 3 glitch types simultaneously. For example, let's take preset number 5, named Color Only, and open the Use Stage 1 tab. Stage order is the parameter that defines the effect priority. There are 3 stages, and if you need to move the selected effect higher than the others in the scene, this is where you set the sequence from 1 to 3. Stage intensity is the individual value of the effect intensiveness. Stage transfer effect is the value of image block movement. Stage effect power is the value of the effect inside the image blocks. Effect type. This parameter sets up the effect that will be applied to the blocks. Transfer type is a type of image block separation. Finally, use the fade-in duration and fade-out duration parameter to define how fast or how slow the effect should appear and disappear. Among these settings, you will see variables. For instance, delta value. This is a random frames generation percentage. When it is equal to 100, all frames are randomly generated. When it's at a 0, you have a static frame. Initial value is the initial generation percentage. Final value is the final generation percentage. The Generate Another Map button helps you quickly see how the selected settings look by watching one frame. You can apply glitch effect to a video, transition, or even to a text object. Did you like this update? Let us know what other tools and features we should cover on our channel. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Until next time!